House of Mercury. The storm funneled through town with destructive intent. Fractured tree limbs, toppled fences, ripped shingles like tufts of hair. Dad woke up to snaps and creaks, the two live oaks in the front yard, but in the backyard, the nearly uprooted fig tree brought him to tears. In the morning, two neighbors, one black, one white, came over to bandage the oaks after debridement. A third, an Indian, stabilized the fig tree, pitched it like a tent with rope and stake. On the second day, I cut up the rest of the branches, deepened the earth for the fig, enjoyed a long, lazy lunch with my parents, and on the way home, heard a radio report on whether the sky is bluer during a pandemic. The third day, I took my son and daughter back. We bundled up the heaps, nursed the flower beds, delighted in another languid lunch, hummus, falafel, shakshuka, followed by tea and stories about fear that comes to nothing. The kids said it was the best falafel they'd ever had, and Mom said that going forward, her morning glories will get the light they deserve.